acquaintance has been so peculiar. When I saw you the first time, I was so afraid of you. So afraid that I couldn't look you in the face. Still, as I came and went, I always found myself near you. I couldn't risk being your enemy, so I became your friend. But there was always a discordant note when you came to our house because I saw that my husband couldn't bear you. And that was as annoying to me as an ill-fitting gown. And I did all I could to make him friendly towards you, but before he consented, you announced your engagement. Then came a violent friendship, so that in a twinkling, it appeared as if you only dared show your real feelings once you were betrothed. And then, how was it later? I didn't get jealous. How wonderful. And I remember when you were Patin's godmother, I made Bob kiss you. He did it, but you were so confused. That is, I didn't notice it at the time, thought about it later, but never thought about it before. Now, why are you silent? You haven't said a word. Let me go on talking. You're sat there and your eyes have loosened out of me all these thoughts that lay like raw silk in their cocoon. Thoughts, suspicious thoughts, perhaps. Let me see. Why did you break your engagement? Why do you come so seldom to the house these days? Well, why won't you visit us tonight?
Like what?
I don't
have to listen. I am not just your baby sister anymore. I am an adult and a mother and a co-owner of this farm. And if I say get off my husband's case, I mean get off my husband's case. If he wants to be on his phone, he will. If he wants to read a book, he will. Hell, if he wants to take up basket weaving, he will. But he does not need your permission, and neither do I. And I have no intention of
dramatic.
I am not being dramatic.
Michael's barricade.
Oh my God, what are we supposed to do?
Get the guns. Get the guns.
nugget nuggets!
Mr. Narrator, sir, please don't die! Please, we have to go on all the wonderful adventures together and the gummy bears! Don't forget the gummy bears!
Callie, Paige, what's the one thing that could bring somebody back to life?
True love's kiss! Of course!
No! I was actually thinking of something a little more thunderous, perhaps.
Oh, goodness. Think, Callie, think! What could possibly bring him?